你可以用那那个三块五毛买几个，对的，多买点啊，两个那行啊。
Primary di super gang sounds.
Open more. LIB2, my fro from the south.
LA, any of you know? What kind of
caps?
Caps.
Nah, there you go.
Thank you.
Senior, one of the
I know there are parts of new machine. What new machine are you talking? Sir, you're buying bow. What's a friend on the phone? One, LID one. Okay. Okay, Abba, one number.
I'm a friend, right? Good man. Yeah, thank you. But a bit tricky time, but can't my set will stand by and then
set
maybe a copy camera and software.
We're not even
now. What's up, bro? I'm not done, but I'm going to see you first.
This is my soul.
Thank you. When in there, everything is in that, but may sense itself. Trying to be a woman of science, as I focus on. Camera. Wife, I need to keep it.
Yeah,
I'm not sure. So come on.
Temporary operating place. Mr. Tia, not be. I'm switching. We are grateful to God for giving us another beautiful day to continue with our own house. This day. We hope that we are going to have a successful day as we had it yesterday. We call on Mr. Bilal, Mr. Abdulukhu, to be very good. But he will be prepared. Sorry to you. Can you put out that sort of thing for the week of life? Thank you for starting this week with us as we go through our in-house review. We commit this event into your hands. We invite your presence to be with us. Guide us through this day. As the children stand before the house to present, give them the courage. Grant them the enablement to deliver. We pray for the heavens to open upon us as an institute. For this spirit, without you, we can do anything. Come with us. At the end of the day, we are the first to say glory to you in the name of Jesus. Thank you. I know I can count on you. Ladies and gentlemen, this morning presentations are on grant health. And the chairman for the morning session is no less a person than Dr. We know he will do a very good job. That's all we can look at into your face. Thank you. Thank you. We are all welcome to this morning's session. The rules of the game have been changed. 15 minutes for the level of division and 10 minutes for others. And when it comes to the time of Dr. Allen, then he will take 20 minutes because of the presenting and the programs. And I believe that when presenters are called upon to go to the program, we try to apply them those who want to finish their presentations. That is the exercise of the library and the interest of the people who are doing that. That is what I said. The call on the head quickly for the Panther Education Dr. Leon Ponce to take his
the man that values our common good is to identify
the man that values our common good is to identify the best fit and money for all has limited to see from
numbers.
The vision has expression. The quality of the quality of our belief that the world shall control and control. Better control and ability are indicated as well. Our current self-strength stands as 45, comprising senior members, technical staff, and other supporting staff. We also have enough good staff and national service personnel. So, the chairman, I'm happy to mention that we have one senior member and 50% use their time. And very newly employed technical staff, we are not grateful, but we are still looking at the doors of community to be as well. Staff on seminar, parenting advice for us on seminar engagement, including prayer, matter of engagement, and more. All of them are pursuing 10-9-10. Half on the planet. Last year, four of us, what we had, two senior members, one senior staff, and another junior staff. We are happy to mention that three of our senior members are on post-retirement contracts. Three of them. And I think it is the largest in the institute. It is not a new achievement. Our specific job description is to detect and diagnose crop diseases and pathogens and screen or develop crop protocols against pest diseases, developing crop diseases and pest management strategies, and pattern literature, student research and adaptive strategy, issuance of import permits, and any responsibility that is dictated by managers. By way of infrastructure, we have offices, labs, greenhouses, and one equipment. We are happy to mention that management has given the vision one vehicle for our activities, the entire vision. By way of our current research service, Dr. Popong is involved in an activity under DMTF and UK8, as well as UNAIDS and the American Aquaculture Regulator. Dr. Popong has an activity under CAPASI, NAMPICA. Myself, I have an activity under HAGRA, and one co-founded by HAGRA and CAPASI, and then another one under CAPASI. Dr. Steve Arumapo has an activity under HAGRA and African Yam. Dr. Eddie Marfo has activities under DOD support. Next Jane and Dr. Hapo Red Mark. Dr. Wahid Branson has activity under Ashanti Red Mark, CAPASI, and DOD. Uma Sanda Issa has activity under DOD support and CAPASI. From my own activities, last year, I was involved in the end and termination of the produce. The end and termination of the produce seed potato crop. And then, efficacy of insect pathogen and then following the well to weight. And genetic diversity of insect pathogen and genetic. Effective following the well to weight. Last year for the end and termination of the pension security projects, which was funded under PEL and Medicare. an apology component. Our great concern was development and application of a modified protocol for isolating insect and vector matters. This has expanded our assessment and given us chances for researching into insect beneficial matters for insect pest management. The last one of the project introduced three of the generators, two by myself and one by the master. And we also contributed one complete paper abstract to the 7th International Meteorology Congress. We thank you to all of the entire research team members for the warm collaboration. There is what I did to do. For this year, for last year, we did it as well. I work on a theory of insect pathogenic nematodes. I just want to move on to the new research. As a standard on the other. This was the team. By way of intro, in Ghana, first report of 400 infestations was recorded in the Mbeki district in the 2016. So samples were sent to the county in the UK and they did positive. So the fight and the struggle against 400 infestations. The most sustainable management strategy has been integrated management. It combines several options into integrated management. That's a new one there. That's a new one that the insect pathogenic nematodes manage several insects. Insect pathogenic nematodes are a group of nematodes that attack and kill insects. On the scale of 1 to 5. This is cross-weeds and My word of completion, I'm saying that this what I am exploring, and need to better exploring. For the year 2021, we are working on different interconnected innovative assets.
Very bad weather. So some of the districts
the demonstrations were not very successful. For instance, you can see on the left that this demonstration was not successful because at the time of turning of the cabin, there was severe drought after the situation. So we had to terminate the demonstration at that point. But for a place like Amasya Center, it was very successful. Even though we planted the demonstration almost at the same time, within the same week, but you can see that there are variations in the rainfall pattern in the various places. So at Amasya Center, it was very successful. We organized through the during the harvesting time. Okay, so you can see the production on harvesting the photo. For the demonstration at Imam Pond, it was just like that of Cedric Mou, but the district decided that they would do a replanting. So they started a new demonstration in January this year, and this was what you see on the right. Okay. This was harvested yesterday. The next step is the management of soil and rain for sustainable food security in Africa, sponsored by Afasi. Here, the task was to identify natural enemies, specifically parasitoids, for the management of soil and rain in Ghana and for Africa as a whole. So there was nationwide collection of soil and rain larvae get parasitoid if possible. And then, so as you can see, that is all anywhere on maize, and this is how larvae were collected. Fortunately, two natural enemy tags or parasitoid tags were identified. And then they were kept. So I think it is a good sign because as we all know, soil armyworm is not native to Africa or Ghana. So if we are able to identify parasitoids here, it means there is proof that we can, in the future, manage soil armyworm using natural enemies. Okay, instead of maybe using natural enemies by importing natural enemies from origin of the pest. So for 2021, this natural enemy exploration for the management of soil armyworm will continue. So that is the thing. Just trying to look at the question here. In 2018, over 20,000 hectares of maize farm were destroyed by soil armyworm. Okay, and the prevalence rate of soil armyworm stands at about 79.5%. So if you enter every maize farm, you will get an average of 79.5% being devastated by soil armyworm. And then yield loss associated with soil armyworm stands at around 45% in 2018. And this translates into about 137 million dollars. Okay, so that is how much Ghana loses as a result of farm deforestation. And then, so the action plan for this year, monitoring to identify natural enemies will continue. And then, in the process, we will have to find out the pest density and crop damage. Okay. And then, once you are able to identify more parasitoids, you will do mass burial at the lab. And then, when you get a lot of parasitoids, then you will conduct a parasitic test. You will infest or you will feed the identified parasitoids. You will give them a fresh larvae of soil armyworm and see the percentage parasitism. And see if it is possible to use natural elements or parasitoid to manage the pest subsequently. Okay, so this is the section I need to do now. It was started last year. This is the So it was started last year, and then it is dual ecosystem services from non-profit managing meditation and replacing for personal. Yeah, we know these are very towers have serious personal the magic. As we all know, the management of this test have probably been the use of synthetic insecticides. Very much so. Habitat manipulation using non-crop plants has the potential to attract natural animals and then attract pollinators to manage the pest when they send down to enhance pollination of this insect pollinator crops. When we say habitat manipulation, it's using non-crop plants to manipulate the cropping environment to attract natural enemies and at the same time provide them with floral resources like nectar and pollen, and at the same time serve them with a conducive habitat. So this is likely to result in conservation by other countries. Let me say conservation by other countries will rely on endemic natural enemies to manage the specific of these new chemicals. So the objective is to manage pests of these crops and then to enhance our region and food safety in both kinds of other areas. So through habitat manipulation plants that have been tried and tested will be selected. One is water, that is Caribbean Tamboré, and then the second is Cedar Sophia, which is also known as Cedar Sophia. So the parameter design will be ICBD, treatment and the treatment will be habitat manipulation only.
But I don't think we have one here.
Habitat manipulation plus insecticide, and then you can see the rest. Okay, so that is how the probe will look like. The probe will be surrounded by habitat manipulation plants, and then the cabbage will be in the middle of the plant. The same will be repeated for okra. So the next one is the management of sea cucumber removal with the planet smart approach. So that is sea cucumber removal in sea, silas from the carriers and then other silas species who are going to appear. So sea cucumber is attacked by silas and it is the most severe pest of the world global. Okay, so that is how. They are. When the adults attack the leaves, and then the larvae attack the tumors in the background center. Okay. When this pest attack the tumors, the plant produces defensive mechanism. So that means the tumor very weak. Not to use as food. And then the probability of fungi and bacteria in question, when these pests attack the tumors. Okay, so we are taking the risk to manage the removal to increase growth and tuber quality. Okay, that is the approach. Planning is still ongoing, so I can't give details methodology. By looking at the process, only one paper was published in the year. Thank you. The next presentation will be done by Dr. Kofi Akinfenwa. Please let's welcome him. We worked on
activity to manage the government account. DBM. But this is a prop. Okay, the prop is there. So, let's really talk about this thing. It was a national issue. The smoke from the street. So, we needed to do something. And my supporter was to do the education for how we can manage this common test. So we had to do some survey when the farmers were identified in the sector that they were using, and also their perception of effectiveness of this insecticide. So we have to profile this insecticide and assess them in the lab to see how they perform. So based on this, we selected. We were to conduct a verification track in the form to see how this insecticide performed. So in all, we buy our seed form of the insecticide and we got to decide to use 10 comprising 5 synthetics and biorational. The focus was to increase the use of biorational for botanical or biological insecticide in the development of this pest. So we have the list here. These are the synthetics, and from here, those are the biological. So, at this moment, we conducted those studies with 30 by 10 meter plot with 1 meter plot. And what we did was we had to apply the insecticide directly at the initial when we transplanted the seedlings. And then from the packing seed, that is where the pest is most devastating. We have to reduce the frequency to weekly spraying. And in the field, we had 2 sessions of inviting farmers to assess the performance of the insecticide, as well as the scientists also assessed. So the farmers had a chance to grant the effectiveness of the insecticide and the pre-capacity before the heads are full, and also during the maturity stage. So this is the result that we have. And looking at an assessment of the number of plants that were damaged, the stand that were damaged, and also the level that will damage. It looks like, as from the previous year, most of the biological insecticides were more effective, particularly Limaza. At the pre-capping stage, you see that the number of pests out of 20 plants, 7 were capped, so trap infestation. And the damage level was very low, 1. In fact, we used a scale of 1 to 5, 1 being lower than 5 highest. And also at the maturity stage, we experienced the same results as seen here. So you see that the performance of Mimaza is exceptional. The only synthetic that came close was the Viper. From the pre-capping and also at the maturity stage. And we understand why, because of the active ingredients of Viper. It has 2 synthetics which are both systemic. One has translaminar action, that means when you apply, it's able to translocate into the leaves and you stay there for some time. As well as the synthetic, we cover the entire plant. So, it's not that it's difficult. But other results also indicate that certain chemicals are used as fuel by the damaged bugs to attack the plant. And it seems most of the synthetics have that activity. So based on our ranking, I think we must have comfort. And the farmers' ranking also shows the same. So these are some of the pictures. This we have one of our close staff applying on the insecticide. And there's a farmer film day that we have. The director should be in here. Yeah, that's our director. We visited us and interacted with the farmers. So this is a session of the farmer. And now for 2021, we'll be looking at how we can focus forward. In fact, this one started with the AGRA, but we couldn't collect enough data to make this one possible because the AGRA project will be expanded, but it will extend the course. So very short, and that is it wasn't complicit. So when capacity came in, we put this out and we are supporting that. This one. So we'll be looking at the relationship between climatic factors such as ability to rainfall, renewable as forecast, the prevalence of output of the fall anyway. So we intend to set up monitoring stations at risk locations where we will use pheromone traps. Thank you. Where you use pheromone traps to monitor the pest population, and you can see how we can use these variables to monitor the model. And the other part will be the second one is the management of young pests in the wake of climate change. In fact, this one comes at the backdrop of climate change, where we are going to see how we manage the pests that attack the air. And first, we do a